나이지리아의 아와이 목사가 한국을 방문했습니다. 본국에서 일하는 무장 테러 단체 보코하람의 기독교 박해 현장을 생생하게 전하기 위해서인데요. 더불어 한국도 극단주의 이슬람주의자들에게 경계를 늦추지 말 것을 당부했습니다. 김효정 기자가 만나봤습니다.
안녕하세요.
안녕하세요.
네, 가장 먼저 목사님에 대한 소개와 이제 사역에 대한 이야기를 좀 들어봐야 될 것 같아요.
My name is Reverend Daniel Dogo Awai. I am thankful to God that He has sent me to Korea. I pastored one of the church in northeastern Nigeria, to be specific. The name of that church is Ekwa Goodness Church in Patuskum, Yobe State. My church in Patuskum really went through a lot of hardship. There was a lot of persecution. In fact, that church has been burned down to ashes about 7 times now by history. Even after the lot of happenings, destruction of the church, members kept on meeting in the church building, in the burned and dilapidated church building to have service as usual.
대표님께 좀 여쭐게요. 이번에 이제 나이지리아 아와이 목사님을 초대해서 굉장히 다양한 이야기들을 들을 수 있는 기회를 마련하셨어요. 순교자의 소리가 지금 어떻게 활동하고 있는지 간단히 좀 듣고 싶고요. 앞으로의 계획이 궁금합니다.
네, 저희 순교자의 소리는 전 세계에 한 30여 개 국가에 나가 있고요. 다 한 나라 한 나라마다 다 독립적인 그런 단체입니다. 저희가 지향하는 그런 선교는 뭐냐면 여기 전 세계에 그러니까 하나님을 믿는다는 그 이유만으로 핍박을 받는 기독교인들을 지원하고 도와주고 또한 또 중요한 거는 저희가 그들에게 배워야 된다는 거예요. 왜냐하면 사실 핍박이 있으면 다 도망가고 싶거든요. 편안하고 싶잖아요. 그렇지만 그리스도의 이름을 위해서 이렇게 끝까지 싸우는 그런 분들한테 저희가 하나가 되어서 서로의 몸의 역할을 한 몸을 이루어야지 하나님이 영광을 받으실 것 같아요. 그래서 그러한 일들을 저희가 하고 있고요. 이번 해부터 저희가 여기 그 각 지역에서 이렇게 핍박받고 있는 지도자들을 모셔서 여기 한국 교회와 함께 나누고 싶어서 계획을 했습니다.
네, 많은 관심이 필요할 것 같고요. 정말 다 같이 깨어서 핍박받고 있는 국가들의 또 교역자들과 또 성도들을 위해서 기도해야 되지 않을까 하는 생각이 듭니다. 네, 지금 나이지리아 같은 경우 특별히 이제 북부가 피해 상황이 굉장히 큰 지금 상태인 거죠.
As you can see, these are names of members who were either killed or wounded. 86 members who are either killed or wounded. And this is just Patuskum area alone. It doesn't cover the whole of the state or the whole of northeastern Nigeria or the whole of northern Nigeria. This is just a small part of northern Nigeria. This happened from the post-election riot in Nigeria. That was during the last election of our president named Goodluck Jonathan, the one before this one that we had last. At the night of that first election riot, about 85% of the churches that we have in Yobe State were destroyed by fire through the handwork of the Islamic militants called Boko Haram and other terrorists. I want to cite example with one of the pastors that was killed night before the Christmas. The name of that pastor is Johannes Sini, a good friend of mine and a very godly man. The members of this sect called Boko Haram extremist group came to his house in the night when he was sleeping together with his entire family. They beheaded him as though they were killing an animal, and they went and met his members in the church having Christmas Eve, and they shot at them and killed three of them through the use of gun. They caught one and went to bush with him and slaughtered him as though they were killing an animal. And all this took place on the eve of Christmas, and they took about 6 hours doing all these things with nobody to stop them from doing this kind of thing. It's as if there were no soldiers, there were no policemen in Nigeria.
기도가 많이 필요한 상황이라는 생각이 들고요. 그런데 이런 상황 가운데도 이제 주님이 역사하시는 순간들이 굉장히 또 제가 많이 있다고 들었습니다. 그 부분에 대해서 좀 이야기를 듣고 싶은데요.
It makes believers to sit up. And then the third benefit of persecution is that it makes believers to be prayerful. It makes believers to study the word of God more than how they have ever studied it. And it makes believers to know that really quite a lot of passages we read in the Bible and a lot of prophecies that we read about in the Bible is true. For Jesus did tell us that they will persecute us. Jesus did tell us that time is coming that when they persecute, they will tell us they are doing God's work. But the joy is that though majority have been killed, though many have sustained injury, though properties worth billions of dollars has been raised down by fire, yet the church is still marching on and the gates of hell cannot prevail.
지금 뭐 여러 가지 메시지를 또 같이 전해주시는 것 같아요. 특별히 한국에 이번에 오게 되셨는데 또 한국 교회와 성도들에게 하실 말씀이 있을 것 같아요.
Those who were killing in Nigeria, those who go about chasing Christians, before they kill, they use the word in Arabic, Allahu Akbar, before they kill people. And so those people are extremists. And if they are extremists, they claim they are Muslim. So if they claim they are Muslim, so it means that even the Muslims that are coming to Korea, in a future to come, there will be extremists among them. And these extremists are likely going to bring into what we experience in Nigeria to come to bear in your country, Korea also. Anywhere Muslims go, they go also with their religion. And anywhere their number increases, they also go with militants who will want to clear sole owners of that land to inherit the land for Islam.
그렇다면 굉장히 저는 좀 두렵게 느껴지기도 하는데요. 이 무슬림에 대한 선교 전략을 우리가 좀 어떻게 가져가야 되는지 좀 들어보고 싶어요.
Please rise up and tell these people about Jesus. It is only through telling these people about the peace and the love that is found in Christ that we are able to stop these terrorists among them from perpetuating all these evils that they are going not only in Nigeria, but almost in quite a number of countries all over the world attacking people just like that.
네, 오늘 말씀 참 잘 들었습니다. 앞으로 한국 교회가 더 깨어서 기도하고 또 나이지리아를 위해서도 우리가 함께 힘을 모아서 기도해야 될 것 같다는 생각이 드네요. 네, 오늘 나와주셔서 감사합니다.
감사합니다.
네, 감사합니다.